continue now on page 120, 121 with the lighting of our Shabbat candles. And I'd like to invite up Betsy and Seth Weissman and Susan and David Ryder to please come and light the candles for us.
As these Shabbat candles give light to all who behold them, so may we, by our lives, give light to all who behold us. As their brightness reminds us of the generations of Israel who have kindled light, so may we, in our own day, be among those who kindle light.
Baruch Atah.
Shabbat Shalom, good morning. I'd like to take a minute to introduce you to our prayer book, in case you're unfamiliar with it. It's a dark blue one that's in the pews in front of you. And if you'd be kind enough to turn to page 228, you'll see down the right-hand side of the page there's Hebrew, and next to the Hebrew is the Hebrew transliterated into English letters. So if your Hebrew is a little rusty, you can still follow along, no problem at all. But know that is a fairly accurate translation of the Hebrew above, and then right at the bottom of the page is some commentary on those prayers. On the left-hand side of the page are two English renderings that pick up the theme of the prayer on the right-hand side, and each one of them is followed by a line in Hebrew. As we go through the service, when Abbie takes over and begins to lead the service, we will do one reading per double page spread. So we'll either read the Hebrew or we'll read one of the English pieces, and basically when we do that, as we read each piece, just turn the page. And that way, you'll keep up with us quite easily. We'll be giving page numbers as well, in case you get left behind. But we do ask that you sing along with us, read along with us, pray along with us, so that we could worship as a kahila, kedusha, a holy community together.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
page 219. Let the soul of everything alive bless your name, Adonai, our God, and the spirit of all flesh glorify and exalt your name forever, O Sovereign. Transcending space and time, you alone are God. We have no sovereign besides you. God of the first and the last, God of all creatures, master of all generations, who is praised in a multitude of praises, who guides the world with abundant loving kindness and all creatures with mercy. Adonai neither slumbers nor sleeps. God awakens the sleeping, arouses those who slumber, gives speech to the mute. God loosens the bond of the captive. God supports the fallen and strengthens those who are bent over. You alone do we acknowledge. Over the page we read together. Even if our mouths were full of song as the sea, and our tongues full of joy in countless waves, and our lips full of praise as wide as the sky's expanse, and were our eyes to shine like sun and moon, if our hands were spread out like heaven's eagles, and our feet swift like young deer, we could never thank you adequately, Adonai, our God and God of our ancestors, to bless your name for a 10,000 of the many myriads of times you granted favors to our ancestors and to us. Therefore, these limbs which you have formed in us, and this spirit and soul that you have breathed into our nostrils, this tongue which you have set in our mouths, they must acknowledge, bless, praise, and glorify your name, O our Sovereign. For every mouth will acknowledge you, every tongue pledge homage to you, every knee bend in your presence, and every upright person shall bow before you. Every heart will revere you, and every inmost thought will sing to your name. And David said, let all my bones exclaim, who is like you, Adonai? David continued, bless Adonai, O my soul, and let my inner being praise your holy name. Continue now with the Katzi Kaddish, which you can find on page 224.
Yikra v'yikrash shmei rava. Balmadi vrachu te viam lich mahute Bechaye chon uviomechon Uvchaye techove Israel Ba'agala uvizman kariv Ve'imaru amen Yeheshmei rabba mevorach Le'olam ulal me'almaya yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitba'ar v'yitromam v'yitnaseh v'yithadar v'yitaleh v'yithalal Shmei dekudisha b'richu Le'elah min kol b'rchata v'shirata Tush b'chata v'nechemata Da'amiran b'yalma v'imaru Amen. Please rise for the call to worship, page 226. We continue on page 228 with Yotzer Or. Please join me. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech ha'olam, Yotzer Or uvarei choshech, Oseh shalom uvarei et hakol, Hameir la'aretz v'ladarim aleha barachamim, Uv tuvo mechadesh b'chol yom tamid ma'aseh reishit. Ma rabu ma asecha Adonai, kulam bechokma asita, mala haaretz kinyanecha, tit barach Adonai Eloheinu, al shavach ma ase yadecha, al gmore or she asita ifa arucha sela, or chadash al tzion ta'ir, Benizkeh kulanu mehera l'oro. Baruch ata Adonai, Yotzer ha'ma'arut. We continue at the bottom of page 231. Love your neighbor as yourself, you said, and light blinded we saw that inner and outer worlds are one, as you are one. You spoke and we wrote. We reached for you down the centuries, your light moving before us. As we climbed, fell back, and climbed again, your Sinai of life. Please be seated. We now continue together with Ve'a Hafta on page 234. Ve'a Hafta Adonai Elohecha B'chol Avavcha U'v'chol Nafshecha U'v'chol Me'odecha V'hayu Hadvarim Ha'ele Asher Anohi Mitzavecha Hayom Olivavecha Vishinatam Livanecha Vidibarta Bam Vishiv Techa Bvetecha Uvlech Techa Vaderech Uvshoch Bacha Uvkumecha Uchshar Tom Leo Al Yadecha Vehayu Litotafo Bain Einecha Uchtav Tom Al Mizizo Betecha Uvisharecha Lama Antis Karu Vaasitem Ed Kol Mitzvotai Vitem Kidoshim Lelohehem Ani Adonai Elohehem Asher Hotzeiti Adhem Me'eretz Mitzrayim Liot Lachem Lelohim Ani Adonai Elohehem. Page 238. For us, this eternal teaching is true and enduring, beloved and precious, awesome, good, and beautiful. The God of the universe is truly our sovereign, the rock of Jacob, our protecting shield. God endures through all generations, God's name persists, God's throne is firm, God's sovereignty and faithfulness last forever. God's words live and endure, faithful and precious for eternity. Together, from Egypt you redeemed us, freeing us from bondage. For that, your beloved sang praise, exalting you. Your dear ones offered hymns, songs, praise, blessing, and thanksgiving to you as sovereign, living and enduring God, high and exalted, great and awesome, God ever humbles the proud, raises the lowly, feeds the imprisoned, redeems the afflicted, helps the oppressed, answering our people when we cry out. Praise to God Most High, blessed is God and deserving of blessing. In great joy, Moses, Miriam, and Israel responded with a song to you, all of them proclaiming.
Thank you.
please rise for tefillah, which begins on page 242. Adonai sefatai tivtach ufi agita hilatecha. Adonai, open my lips that my mouth may declare your praise. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu velohei avoteinu v'imoteinu. Elohei Abraham, Elohei Yitzchak, Elohei Yaakov, Elohei Sarah, Elohei Rivka, Elohei Rachel, Elohei Leah, Ha'el Hagadol, Hagibor Vehanora, El Elyon, Gomel Hasadim Tovim, Vekone Hakol. Bezocher haste avovim ahod, umevig ula livne vnehem, lima an shemo beahava, melech ozer umoshia umakin. Baruch ata Adonai, magen Abraham, vezrat Sarah. Ata givor leolam Adonai, Mechaye HaKol, Ata Rav Lehoshia, Morid Hata. Mechalkel Hayim Bechesed, Mechaye HaKol Berachamim Rabim. Somech Noflim Verofei Holim, Umatir Asurim. Umakayem emunato lishenei afar Michamocha ba'al givuro umidom elach Melech memid umakayem umatzmiach Yeshua V'ne'emanata l'achayo hakol Baruch ata Adonai, Mechaye HaKol.
Page 248.
Nekadesh et Shimcha ba'olam, Keshem shemakdishim oto bishmei marom, Kakatuva yad nevi'echa, Vikaraze elzeve amar Kadosh, Kadosh, Kadosh Adonai Tzevaot Melo kol haaretz Kivodo Adir, Adirenu Adonai Adoninu ma'adir shim Chabacho haaretz Baruch kivod Adonai mimkomo Echad hu Eloheinu Hu avinu hu malkeinu Hu moshienu v'hu yashmienu Barachamav le'ene kol hai Ani Adonai Eloheihem Yimloch Adonai le'olam Elohai yitzion L'dor v'ador Hallelujah L'dor v'ador L'dor v'ador L'dor v'ador Nagigod lecha L'dor v'ador L'dor v'ador L'dor v'ador Nagigod lecha Ulnetzach netzachim Kedushatecha nakdish Kedushatecha nakdish V'shivchacha Eloheinu Mipinu lo yamush Le'olam le'olam va'ed L'dor v'ador L'dor v'ador L'dor v'ador Nagigod lecha
L'dor v'ador.
L'dor v'ador.
L'dor v'ador nagigod lecha. Baruch atah Adonai ha'el ha'kadosh.
To all generations we will declare your greatness, and for all eternity proclaim your holiness. Your praise, O God, shall never depart from our lips. Blessed are you, Adonai, the holy God. Please be seated. We continue at the middle of page 253. Where has this week vanished? Is it lost forever? Will I ever recover anything from it? The joy of life, the unexpected victory, the realized hope, the task accomplished? Will I ever be able to banish the memory of pain, the sting of defeat, the heaviness of boredom? On this day, let me keep for a while what must drift away. On this day, let me be free of the burdens that must return. On this day, Shabbat, abide. Help me to withdraw for a while from the flight of time. Contain the retreat of the hours and days from the grasp of frantic life. Let me learn to pause, if only for this day. Let me find peace on this day. Let me enter into a quiet world this day. On this day, Shabbat, abide. We continue responsively in the middle of page 255. On this holy Shabbat, may we draw nearer to life, to peace, and to joy. True rest, holiness in our deeds, worth in our study of Torah. Let us feed on the love of goodness. Let us drink from the love of goodness. Restrain our thirst for excess and cleanse our hearts to serve life well. On this holy Shabbat, may we draw nearer in life, in peace, and in joy. On page 257, please respond, Modim Anachnu Lach, which means, we thank you. For the expanding grandeur of creation, worlds known and unknown, galaxies beyond galaxies, filling us with awe and challenging our imaginations, Modim Anachnu Lach. For this fragile planet Earth, its times and tides, its sunsets and seasons, Modim Anachnu Lach. For the joy of human life, its wonders and surprises, its hopes and achievements, Modim Anachnu Lach. For human community, our common past and future hope, our oneness transcending all separation, our capacity to work for peace and justice in the midst of hostility and oppression, Modim Anachnu Lach. For high hopes and noble causes, for faith without fanaticism, for understanding of views not shared. Modim anachnu lach. For all who have labored and suffered for a fairer world, who have lived so that others might live in dignity and freedom. Modim anachnu lach. For human liberties and sacred rights, for opportunities to change and grow, to affirm and choose. Modim anachnu lach. We pray that we may live not by our fears, but by our hopes, not by our words, but by our deeds. Blessed are you, Adonai, your name is goodness, and you are worthy of thanksgiving. Page 259. We oughtn't pray for what we've never known, and humanity has never known. Unbroken peace, unmixed blessing, no. Better to pray for pity, for indignation, discontent, the will to see and touch, the power to do good and make new. We pray silently.
Seder Kriyat HaTorah, service for reading of Torah this morning, begins on page 362. As we pass the Torah down the generations, I'd like to invite Abby's parents, Betsy and Seth, as well as her grandparents, Susan and David Ryder, and Arlene and Stuart Herman, to please come forward and join us up on the pulpit. I'd also like to invite John and Colleen McGowan to please come forward to help us open the ark. Please rise.
Dear Abbie, today is a momentous occasion. Your bat mitzvah and the passing of the Torah to you marks your transition from childhood to adulthood. That is, according to the Jewish religion, you'll now be a woman. And that leaves us with a range of feelings. We're so proud of you and very excited for you, yet we cannot believe our little girl has grown up so quickly. But as my grandmother, who cannot be here today, would say, time marches on. Abbie, as I pass this Torah to you, you should know that the passing of the Torah from your grandparents to your parents to you is symbolic of the link to the different generations and the way we as Jews pass down our traditions. These traditions include the holidays that we celebrate, the stories and mythology of our people, the food we eat, and the way in which we hold family and friends dear to our hearts. Simply put, the passing of the Torah should remind you of those who came before you. Please accept this Torah as an ongoing connection to your family, to Judaism, and to God. It is our sincere hope that you also pass it along to your children someday.
Dear everybody, I want to thank you for coming. Today is a special day for me, and I'm really glad that you can all be a part of it. I'm so honored and proud to be accepting the Torah today. Since kindergarten, I've been preparing for this day, and I can't believe it's finally here. Studying to become a bat mitzvah was not easy, but I'm very glad I did it. The experience is one that has, in part, taught me how to persevere, and I will look back on this experience when I come across future obstacles. Throughout the last few years of school, dance, lacrosse, and other activities, Hebrew school was a priority. Last summer, I went to Israel with my dad, grandparents, aunt and uncle, and cousins, and it was really great. During the trip, I learned about the history of the Jewish people and the importance of many of the historic sites around the country. Along with other Jewish kids who were on the trip, I took part in a B'nai Mitzvah service on Masada. That was a special thing to me because I felt really connected to my Jewish heritage. Today is also very special to me and marks the day that I become a young adult in the Jewish community. I think becoming an adult means different things to different people. For me, it's a very important milestone. While I can't drive and I can't vote, I feel an added sense of responsibility for the things that I will do in the future. I am looking forward to making more decisions about what I do with my life, and I am so excited for everything that awaits me. Finally, there are two people whom I have to thank for today and a whole lot more. Mom and Dad, thank you for always helping me, for being there for me, and for everything else on a long list of things that you do. I love you.
Thank you. she'll read this, and then we'll, and we've got all that.
I'd like to invite Sharon and Bob Krakowski forward to please help us undress the Torah. Please be seated.
It's just, Robin, if you can hang on to that for me for 1 second, let's just find a place. Yeah? Okay.
The Torah portion I shall be reading from today is entitled Shalah Lecha. It comes from the book of Numbers, chapter 14, verses 5 through 19. This portion is about when Moses finally gets to the edge of the promised land before 40 years in the desert. The Israelites do not have faith in God, and God is not happy about that. Moses convinces God that he is more powerful when he is kind and slow to anger, rather than revengeful. You may follow along in your Torah commentary on page 443.
Ya'amdu la Torah, Daniel, Yonatan, Yoel, b'nei David, u'Alexandra, b'nei Yoel. Daniel, Jonathan, Joel, and Alexandra, Ryder. Yeah.
Baruch Adonai Hamarach Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch Adonai Hamarach Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch Adonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam. Asher Bachrnu Mikol Ha'amim V'natan Lanu Et Torato. Baruch Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen.
Amen. Vayipol Moshe v'Aharon al p'neihem lifnei kol kahal adah b'nei Yisrael v'Yehoshua b'Nun v'Chalif ben Yefune min hatarim et ha'aretz kara'u b'gdeihem Vayomeru el kol adah b'nei Yisrael lemor ha'aretz asher avarnu va latur ota tova ha'aretz ma'od ma'od im hafetz banu Adonai vehei vi otanu el ha'aretz hazot untana lanu eretz asher hin Zavat chalav udavash, ach badonai, al timrodu ve'atem, el tira'u et am ha'aretz, ki lachmeinu hem, sar tzilam me'alehem, vadonai itanu al tira'u, vayomeru kol ha'eda, Lirgom otam bavanim uchvod Adonai nira ba'ohel mo'ed el kol b'nei Yisrael.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam asher natan lanu Torah emet
Ya'amdu la Torah, Elisheva bat David, v'chaim shalom ben Ruvein. Seth and Betsy Weissman.
Baruch Adonai Hamarach,
Baruch Adonai Hamarach Le'olam Ba'ed,
Baruch Adonai Hamarach Le'olam Ba'ed, Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam, Asher Baruch Avanu Mikol Amim, V'natan Lanu Et Torato, Baruch Atah Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen.
Amen. Vayomer Adonai El Moshe Ad Ana Yina Atsuni Ha'am Hazeh Va'ad Ana Lo Ya'aminu Vi Bechol Ha'otot Asher Asiti Bekirbo Akenu Va'deiver Va'od Rishenu Va'e'eseh Otecha Lirgoy Gadol Va'atsumi Menu Vayomer Moshe El Adonai V'shamu Mitzrayim Ki ha'elita v'huchacha et ha'am hazeh mikirbo. Ve'amru el yoshev ha'aret hazot sham'u ki ata Adonai bekerev ha'am hazeh asher ayin ba'ayin nir'a ata Adonai va'anancha omed aleihem uvamud anan ata holech lifnehem yomam uvamud esh laila.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam asher natan lanu Torat emet v'chayei olam natan b'tochenu Baruch atah Adonai noten ha'Torah.
Amen. Ta'amod la Torah Ruvenu Elisheva habat mitzvah.
Baruch et Adonai Hamvorach.
Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Le'olam Va'ed.
Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Le'olam Va'ed. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam Asher Bachar Banu Mikol Ha'amim V'natan Lanu Et Torato Baruch atah Adonai Noten HaTorah.
Amen.
V'hemata Et ha'am hazeh ke'ish echad ve'amaru hagoyim asher sham'u et shimacha lemor mi bilti yecholet Adonai lehevi et ha'am hazeh el ha'aretz asher nishbach lahem v'yish hatem bamidbar ve'ata yigdana koach Adonai ka'osher dibarta lemor Adonai erech apayim v'rav chesed nose avon v'afasha v'nake lo yinake poked avon avot abanim ashileshim va'aribeim shelach nal avom ha'am hazeh kegodel chastecha
v'cha asher nasata la'am hazeh mi Mitzrayim v'ad heina. Then Moses and Aaron fell on their faces before the assembled congregation of Israelites. And Joshua, son of Nun, and Caleb, son of Jephunneh, of those who had scouted the land, rent their clothes, and exhorted the whole Israelite community. The land we traversed and scouted is an exceedingly good land. If pleased with us, the Eternal will bring us into that land, a land that flows with milk and honey, and give it to us. Only you must not rebel against the Eternal. Have no fear then of the people of the country, for they are our prey. Their protection has departed from them, but the Eternal is with us. Have no fear of them. As the whole community threatened to pelt them with stones, the presence of the Eternal appeared in the tent of meeting to all the Israelites. And the Eternal One said to Moses, "How long will this people spurn me, and how long will they have no faith in me, despite all the signs that I have performed in their midst? I will strike them with pestilence and disown them, and I will make of you a nation far more numerous than they." But Moses said to the Eternal, "When the Egyptians, from whose midst you brought up this people in your might, hear the news, they will tell it to the inhabitants of that land. Now they have heard that you, Eternal One, are in the midst of this people, that you, Eternal One, appear in plain sight when your cloud rests over them, and when you go before them in a pillar of fire by night. If then you slay this people, every single person, the nations who have heard your fame will say, 'It must be because the Eternal was powerless to bring that people into the land promised them on oath, that God slaughtered in the wilderness.' Therefore, I pray, let my Lord's forbearance be great, as you have declared, saying, 'The Eternal, slow to anger and abounding in kindness, forgiving iniquity and transgression, yet not remitting all punishment, but visiting the iniquity of parents upon children, upon the third and fourth generations. Pardon, I pray, the iniquity of this people according to your great kindness, as you have forgiven this people ever since Egypt.'" Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, asher natan lanu Torah emet, v'chayei olam nata v'docheinu, baruch atah Adonai, notein ha-Torah.
Amen. Having just heard the words of Torah, we now take a moment to think of those of our friends and family who are in need of healing and join together in a Misha Berach prayer of healing on their behalf, which you can find in the middle of page 371.
As we redress the Torah, I'd like to invite Bruce and Barbara Rose to please come forward and help us do that. The rest of the congregation, please rise. Please be seated.
Okay, ma'am.
For my Haftarah portion, I shall be reading from the book of Joshua, chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. This portion is about when Joshua sends two spies to collect battle information about the city of Jericho. The spies meet a woman named Rahab, who not only hides them from the authorities and gives them valuable information, but also lies about their whereabouts to help them. You may follow along in your Torah commentary on page 998. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Ha'olam Asher bachar binviim tovim baratzah v'divrehem hane'emarim be'emet baruch atah Adonai haboher batorah uvmoshe avdo uvisrael amo uvinviei ha'emet vatzedek. Vayishlach Yehoshua bin Nun min hashitim shenayim anashim maraglim cheresh lemor lechu re'u et ha'aretz ve'et yiricho vayelchu vayavo'u Be'isha zona Ushma Rahav Vayishkevu Shama Vaye Amar Lemelech Yiriho Lemor Hine Anashim Ba'u Heina Halayla Mibnei Yisrael Lachpor Et Ha'aretz Vayishlach melech Yiriho el Rahav lemor hotzi'i ha'anashim habaim alayich Asher ba'u leveteich ki lachpur et kol ha'aretz ba'u vatika ha'isha et shnei ha'anashim vatitz b'no vatomer kein ba'u alai ha'anashim v'lo yadati me'ayich heima Vayhi hashar lizkor b'choshech v'ha'anashim yatsa'u lo yadati anach halchu ha'anashim ridfu maher ahareihem ki tasikum Vehi he'elatam ha'gaga Vatit menem bafishte ha'etz Ha'aruchot la al ha'gag V'ha'anashim radfu ahareihem Derech hayardein al ha'mabarot V'hashar sagaru Aharei ka'asher yatsa'u harodfim ahareihem. Joshua, son of Nun, secretly sent two spies from Shittim, saying, "Go explore the countryside of Jericho." When they got to Jericho, they came to the house of a woman named Rahab and stayed there. Someone told the king of Jericho that some Israelites had come that night to spy out the country. So he sent word to Rahab, "The men who have just arrived and are in your house have come to spy out the whole country. Bring them out." But instead, the woman had taken the two men and hidden them. So she answered, "Yes, indeed, the men did come to me, but I didn't know where they were from. They left as it was getting dark, just before the city gates were closed. I don't know where they were going, but if you hurry after them, you can catch them." Actually, she had taken them up to the roof and hidden them under some stalks of flax that she had arranged for herself. The pursuers went as far as the Jordan and as far as the fords, and as soon as they left the town, the gate was shut.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam Tzor kol ha'olamim, tzadik b'chol ha'doro, ha'el ha'ne'eman, ha'omer v'osei, ha'mdaber u'mekayim, shechol devarav, emet v'atzedek, al ha'torah, va'al ha'avodah, va'al ha'nvim, va'al yom ha'shabbat ha'zeh, shenatata lanu, Adonai Eloheinu, Likdu shavlim nucha, lachavod ultifaret. Al hakol Adonai Eloheinu, anachnu modim lach, umavarchim otach, yitbarach shimcha, befi kol hai, tamid l'olam va'ed, baruch atah Adonai. Mekadesh ha-shabbat.
In my Torah portion, Moses sends 12 spies into Canaan to find out if his people would be safe there. When the 12 spies come back, 10 of them basically say, "There is no way we can go there. The people are too big and too strong." However, two other spies, Caleb and Joshua, say, "We can do it as long as we have God on our side." The Israelites listen to the 10 people who said no, instead of Caleb and Joshua. God is not very happy at all and is threatening to punish them all. Moses then talks to God and tries to be reasonable. He tells God to be merciful and not nasty. In the end, to punish them, God makes the Israelites wander in the desert for 40 years because they didn't have faith in God's promise to them. When I read this story, the first thing I thought of was, why are 10 people against going into Canaan while two are not? I believe one reason was that the Israelites felt inferior because they had been slaves in Egypt for such a long time. They had been beaten down physically and spiritually for so long that they had lost the ability to have hope, to see the potential of new opportunities and to have faith in God. As a result, they must have felt there is no point in even trying to get into Canaan. When I compare this passage to everyday life, I thought it was logical to assume that if one only sees the difficulties and challenges in a task, it makes sense that one will not even try to accomplish it. However, if one looks for and sees the benefits in accomplishing the task, doing so will make the difference in the effort that one actually puts forth. Joshua and Caleb were able to see the land of Canaan flowing with milk and honey, and consequently, they knew the benefits of entering would outweigh any of the potential dangers. One way this Torah portion connects to my life involves my move from Connecticut to Virginia almost 3 years ago. At the time of my move, I chose to focus on the new and exciting things about Virginia, like new friends and family, a new school, and new activities. I chose to focus on the benefits, not the difficulties, like missing my family and my Connecticut friends. Focusing on the benefits and positives allowed me to be happy and not sad about the change. This Torah portion addresses the issue of how we face adversity. Its intent is to let us know that even when there are big obstacles in our lives, the approach we take when dealing with them is what's key. If we approach obstacles in a positive way, we will have a greater likelihood of creating a positive and happy outcome for ourselves. If we approach obstacles with a negative attitude, we will almost guarantee ourselves a negative outcome. A great example of this occurred when my Odyssey of the Mind team and I made it to the World Finals during our first year competing. Odyssey of the Mind is an organization where kids solve problems through performances and team competitions. There are multiple competitions that a team is required to win before qualifying for the World Finals. During all the preparation leading up to the competitions and throughout the competitions themselves, my team and I worked very hard and remained positive. We could have easily quit on many occasions because the project we had built was kind of flawed and because we knew we had some tough competition. But we didn't. That positive focus and belief that we had in ourselves drove us to compete on a world stage. As you might have guessed, I think it is much better to be more like Joshua and Caleb than the 10 other spies. While I was preparing for my bat mitzvah, there are many obstacles for me to overcome, some more difficult than others. When I first saw my Haftarah portion, I thought, there is no way I'll be able to do this. However, when I started learning it piece by piece, and with the help from my tutor and parents, it became easier. While these learning obstacles were very important for me to overcome, they were nothing like those which people around the world face every day. I have been taught by my parents that it is my duty to help others who are less fortunate than I am. So for my bat mitzvah project, I carefully chose a charity that helps others to overcome obstacles. I worked hard to help my mom hold a successful yard sale that raised a lot of money for Heifer International. Heifer International's mission is to provide families a hand up, not just a hand out, by empowering them to turn lives of hunger and poverty into self-reliance and hope. In conclusion, Joshua and Caleb chose to see the land of Canaan as one flowing with milk and honey, and not as a place full of tough guys, challenges, and difficulties. This kind of approach to life can be the difference between failure and accomplishment, and sadness and happiness. As a lot of you know, we live on the grounds of George Washington and Martha Washington. I think Martha Washington echoed these sentiments best when she said, "I'm determined to be cheerful and happy, no matter the situation I may be. For I have also learned from experience that the greater part of our happiness or misery depends on our dispositions, not upon our circumstances."
Abbie, this morning you led us in our service. You are Shtichat Zibur, and not only read out of Torah on behalf of all of us here this morning, but indeed gave us, I think, a really, really insightful Devar Torah, and shared not only your optimism, but I think made all of us feel that indeed there's you know, looking at things optimistically is certainly the way to go. There is no doubt in my mind that you brought a great deal of blessing, not only to the front couple of rows here, but to all your family and friends who are with you this morning and have been witness to this transition and this passage within your life. Now it's our turn to return some of those blessings to you. So to begin with, I'd like to invite your parents to please come back and join us up on the pulpit again. Betsy, Seth, yeah. Stand in the middle here so your mom can get in there. We've got a whole box of tissues. Yeah.
I'll do my best, okay. Thank you for being here to celebrate the hard work and dedication of our daughter, Abbie Rose, on becoming a bat mitzvah. Making this day happen has been both an overwhelming and wonderful experience. For me, it is these milestones in life that are so important and made more meaningful by sharing with our closest friends and family. And I want to thank Abbie Rose for your patience, your unending kindness, and you always seeing the humor in most situations that I seem to get us into. Learning how to parent you has definitely made me a better person. You are my extraordinary gift. I'm sorry. I came prepared. And being your mom has been the most wonderful journey. I am so grateful for the wisdom of God, for the matchmaking that He does. I'm sorry. That He does between children and parents. Okay. So you've made it this far, Abbie. Now what? What will your focus be? Well, may I make a suggestion? Let us use the wisdom of our rabbis as a guide. One wise rabbi once said, each person is sent down in this world in order to fulfill a specific divine task, to carry out on earth a lofty heavenly purpose. So this is your new focus, honey. Figure out and complete your given purpose. Take your God-given talents and traits that are found inside of you and pursue your holy purpose. Everything you need already lies within you. Now it's only a matter of figuring it out. It is our greatest wish that you live as God would have you live. Keep your purpose and remember who you want to be and stay on that path. You already have a great start. I recently read a quote by a kindergarten teacher who has been teaching for 20 years, and she said, "One thing I've learned is that the person your child is in kindergarten is the person that they are as adults." And I read that and I said, yes. From the start, you were this cool, easygoing, funny, and wicked cool little person that your daddy and I could not get enough of. And it just keeps getting better. Keep the spirit of that little person alive and you can't possibly go wrong. So, some practical advice as you walk down this path. Continue to find the humor and lightness in most situations. Listen to your instincts. You know better than anyone if something is right. Be curious and adventurous and fearless. Make a difference. Don't sit back and watch others play. Go for it. Take risks. Be involved and help other people. Honor your Jewish heritage and traditions. Have a purpose in life. May you continue to be a blessing to others. And may you continue to allow Judaism to help shape you into a better human being. Life is about making choices. May you have the courage and good judgment to make good choices in your life. We love you.
In a moment, Angela and I will be taking Abbie and her parents up to the ark to offer our own blessing. And as we do so, I ask that each and every one of you will offer up your own personal blessing for Abbie and her family as we do so.
Thank you.
onto her shoulder here.
Yeverechecha Adonai v'yishmarecha.
May God bless you and keep you.
Ya'er Adonai panav inecha v'chunecha.
May God's countenance shine upon you and may God be gracious to you. May the light of God's love shine very, very brightly within your life and give you peace all the days of your life. And let us say, Amen.
Thank you.
Please turn now back into your prayer books to page 374 as we prepare to return the Torah to the Ark. And I'd like to invite Joanna and David Heyman to please come forward and help us open the Ark. The rest of the congregation, please rise. Yahalulu et Shem Adonai ki nisgav shemo levado. The Alenu begins at the bottom of page 586, 586, continues at the top of 588. Please be seated. Our thoughts turn to those who have departed this earth, our own loved ones, those whom our friends and neighbors have lost, the martyrs of our people whose graves are unmarked, and those of every race and nation whose lives have been a blessing to humanity. As we remember them, we meditate on the meaning of love and loss, of life and death. As we remember Shalom Glicksman, Paul Anderson, Lois Goodman, Larry Cohen, Emmanuel Feldman, Rabbi Frank Sundheim, and those whose yahrzeits occur at this time, Mary Abramson, Ruth Brown, Hedwig Dreyfus, Madeline Farrago, Kate Fenio, Abraham Fortunoff, Cecile Ecker Frank, Lawrence Gary, Louise Goldsmith, Nettie Goldstein, Ruth Greenbaum, Muriel Gertzman, Arthur Hankin, Jacob Horowitz, Samuel Imberg, Stephanie Jacobson, Harry Kahn, Bessie Carroll, Bruce Casolo, Robert Klauber, Joseph Leiter, Rose Levinson, Rebecca Lees, Rose Marks, Bernice Meiselman, Bernard David Miller, Emmanuel Miller, David Posnick, Betty Reed, Wade Roper, Cecilia Rosenberg, Max Rosenfeld, Dora Rothman, Aaron Shapiro, Harold Shapiro, Joseph Shiplett, Morris Silverman, Leo Weil, Milton Wessel, and Helen Wiener. Are there any other yahrzeits anyone would like to remember this morning? If so, please call out the names. Hamakom yinachem etchem b'toch sharei avle tzion v'rushalayim. May God comfort you amongst all who mourn in Zion and Jerusalem. The rest of the congregation, please rise now. So we join together in our Kaddish prayer on page 598. Yit gadol v'yit gadash shemei rabah v'yoma divrach yirutei v'yamlich malchutei v'chaye chon v'yome chon v'chaye dechol beit Yisrael v'agala uvizman kariv v'imru amen yehe shmei rabah mevarach le'olam l'olmeil maya yit barach v'yishtabach v'yit pa'av v'yitramam v'yitnase Vit hadar vitale vitalal shmei de kucha berichu leila min kol birchata v'shirata tushbechata v'nechemata tamiran v'yoma v'imru amen yehei shlama rabba min shmaya v'chayim aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen ose shalom bimromav huya ase shalom aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen. May the source of peace send peace to all who mourn, comfort all who are bereaved, and let us say, Amen. Please be seated. Okay, what are we going to complete?
Please join me in our closing song, Eighteen Okeinu, which can be found on page 626.
Ein Kaloheinu, Ein Kadoneinu. Ein kemalkeinu, ein kemoshienu, ein keloheinu, mi chadoneinu, mi kemalkeinu, mi kemoshienu, nor eloheinu, nor leladoneinu, nor lelamalkeinu, lomachienu, baruch eloheinu, Baruch Adonainu, Baruch Mokeinu, Baruch Moshienu, Atahu Eloheinu, Atahu Adonainu, Atahu Malkeinu, Atahu Moshienu. Abby, could I have you back up here, please? You want to do it again? Abby, we have some gifts for you that we'd like to present you. First of all, on behalf of our Women of Reform Judaism and our Men of Reform Judaism, our Brotherhood, I'd like to invite Jeremy Flax to please come forward and present you with a Kiddush cup.
Hey, Rabbi. Hi, Abby. Now, Abby, usually there's no drama associated with presenting the Kiddush cup, but that wasn't the case with your Kiddush cup this morning. I'm sure you've already learned in life that sometimes things just don't go as planned, and you're going to probably discover more of that as time goes on. So when I arrived at the synagogue, I searched diligently where those little elves who make and deliver the Kiddush cup are supposed to leave this. And guess what? They were playing hide and seek, and they were winning. I even got up in the middle of the service to find this Kiddush cup, and I was going to pinch their ears if I could find them and make them put it back, but I couldn't get them, and no Kiddush cup. So I listened to your Devar Torah. I had no Kiddush cup. And I'm thinking, that's kind of inspiring. I'm going to have to somehow make the best of this. And I was going to introduce you to the concept of an IOU. But to complete the miracle of your bat mitzvah literally 4 minutes ago, literally, this Kiddush cup arrived in my hands. So thankfully, Abby, I have it for you. It's a lovely inscribed, I think, ceramic goblet. And, of course, it says, in honor of Abbie Weissman on her bat mitzvah, June 1st, 2013. So I'm very happy to be able to present this to you today on behalf of the men and women of Reform Judaism, and I hope that many years down the road, as you save this cup and look at it on a shelf, you take it out one day and remember all the good times you had here at Beth El in Alexandria. Mazel tov.
Thank you.
Thank you, Judah. And now, on behalf of our whole congregation, I'd like to invite our Executive Vice President, Nancy Pilchin, to please present Abby with her certificate.
So, you are definitely an old soul, and I think there's very few of us, even older souls, in the audience and who are sitting here this morning who didn't just think really long and hard about the thoughts that you shared with us and how relevant they are to life. And then it was pretty funny that it was really relevant to Jeremy. But I, you know, my theory in life, and I always say to my kids, and you've already learned this really well, is if you can't change the facts, change how you view the facts. And, you know, that's just in essence what you said, and I think it's a great message. And you've clearly brought such honor to our congregation, to your family that has come. So from afar, and you know, we're just delighted to be able to share it with you this morning, and I know I echo everybody here in those same thoughts. I'd just like to read for a minute what it says on your bat mitzvah certificate. The world is sustained by three things. In becoming a bat mitzvah, Abbie Weissman has accepted the privileges and responsibilities of being a Jew, lifelong Torah study and the keeping of mitzvot, Shabbat, holy day, and life cycle observances, participation in the life of the synagogue, the Jewish community, and Israel, dedication to tikkun olam, the perfection of our world. And I have no doubt that you will be following this as you get older, and we'll be hearing more about Abbie Weissman. We have a couple of other things that we'd like to share with you. One is a one-year JCC Northern Virginia teen membership, which you can enjoy, hopefully. And the other one is a $250 gift certificate in honor of your bat mitzvah from the North American Federation of Temple Youth for travel to Israel on a nifty high school summer or semester program. And how wonderful that you've already had a chance to experience that trip. So hopefully you have another chance to go back and enjoy it as well. So congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. I'd now like to invite all of Abby's friends, cousins, to please come forward and join us up on the pulpit here.
Shabbat Shalom.
Got
make sure this doesn't get left behind. This just came.
Thank you. friendly. So yes, so we're out today.